Well, hello, good afternoon, and welcome to a warm sunny Bootham Crescent for today's last game at the Crescent charity match between the Reds and the Blues. All proceeds from today's game will be split between the York Teaching Hospital Charity and the York City Football Club Academy. The players and managers from both sides have paid to be involved in today's match. And via this live stream broadcast, the virtual Teamster facility is open this afternoon for donations. So a big thank you to everybody who's contributed so far, and there's plenty of time. Throughout the afternoon, contribution, just go to the York City store for the details. And so to the teams, the Reds currently supported by St. Smith, managed by Richard Debenham, and the Blues managed by Simon Hyde, supported by the Blues. Both teams have been out on the pitch for over half an hour, and hopefully they'll have a selective starting 11, but in the meantime, the two squads this afternoon will start with the Reds, as I say, managed by Richard Debenham, number 2, Joe Scarborough, 3, James Allen, 5, Peter Whaley, 7, Rob Lee, not the next Newcastle player, I think. Number 8 is Tom Hoff, 9 is Nick Pratt, 10, George Allen, 11, the captain, Tom Young, 14, Andy Cunningham, number 1 and in goal is James Brown, 18, Tom Littlesworth, 20, Peter Newark, 21 is Dell O'Brien, 23 Thomas Brown, 29 is James Warren. The Blues this afternoon, managed by Simon Hyde, the suited and booted Simon Hyde, having goal from Dominic McGregor, 2 James Keller, 3 Ray Lewis, 7 Toby Johnson, 9 Seth Salvey, 10 Chris Rothbank, 11 Sam Bander, 12 is Curtis Roberts. Captain is number 14, Yaris van der Veer. 16, Pete Marshall. 17 is Zav Edmonds. 21, Samuel Fox. 25 is Rob Spiro. 26, Chris Tune. 27, Joe Rodgers. 58 is Richard Woft. Our match officials this afternoon, the referee is Mr. Craig Atkin. Father and son, lad and dad, running the line, assistants Martin and Matt Crosby. Kickoff is roughly about 5 minutes away. As I say, the weather is warm, sunny, pitch looks dry. Hopefully an entertaining game. Kickoff is about 5 minutes away. Everybody on the live feed, there's a chance to get involved the second in the interactive chat. So please get involved and don't kick off now, 3 minutes away. Teams have been selected. Welcome on if you're just joining us on the live stream for this, the final, last game at the Crescent charity match between the Reds and the Blues. All proceeds from today's game will be split between the two charity and the Master Football Club Academy. The players and managers from both sides have paid to be involved in today's match. chance, unfortunately, to have that facility. This afternoon, all donations go to the Crescent store. Toss has been won and they're changing heads. Two captains for the Reds this afternoon. Captain number 11, that's one. Captain for the Blues, 10, Chris Brooksman. Your referee, Craig Atkin, like I say. Father and son running the line this afternoon. Martin. So just moments away from kick-off. Hold on to your hats, this could be an epic match.
Run your...
Rodgers for the Blues. Early pressure from the Reds. And we'll get the ball into the box. Test out the field. Nice little ball lane. Intricate bit of passing, but it comes to nothing. Blues now a chance to clear. On the right side. Intercepted by the Reds, but the Blues. Stream. A number of the seats in the pop stand have now gone. Graham's starting to get bare as the quick pairs to finally Blues trying to get the ball out, but they've done that. They've cleared the danger.
He's working the ball down the line. ball around. Put inside the net, so it takes a long time to run. Touch with his clearance and comes scurrying into the what remains is the pop stand behind the ball.
Rodgers on the ball, plays it to Brooksbank, ball over the top, little flick on, and number two for the next Joe Scarborough. sweeps up Neil Dellinger, plays the ball to Penny.
Yeah, good.
Sheffield City goal scorer, of course, was Tommy Mitchell, 1932, who 31st of the stopped up in 1932. Down the wing to Toby Johnson. Johnson beats his man, cuts inside, hits it up, and luckily hits it into one of his better players. And he's able to clear up any danger. Edmonds to throw, finds Fox. Fox lifts the ball over. Johnson, ball across. It's Curtis Roberts. So, Roberts are able to break from George Allen. And a pass. Picked up by Keller. Keller now going forward. And there's a chance here for the Blues to get the ball across. Cunningham has stopped there for the loss. It's cleared. Fires the ball forward. Played on. Pratt is now got room to play the ball across. King gets it on the ball. Unfortunately, there wasn't a red on hand. He was able to clear the danger. The ball's now halfway with Fox coming forward. As I say, it's end to end stuff this. Fielders, Fox in a bit of space, a lot of space. He's taken the ball wide, he's looking for a cutback, which he does. Finds Chris Chu, first time watching Chris Chu this afternoon, the clan club man. Ball in. Oh, yeah. Oh dear. And I'm gone. Who'd have thought it? I'm gone. I knew it. Chris Chu with the cross. I'm sure we'll hear a lot about that right today. 1-0 to the Reds. 16 minutes on the clock. And if you are enjoying this afternoon's entertainment, remember the virtual turnstile facility is available for donations. All proceeds from today's game split between the York Teaching Hospital Charity and the York City Football Club Academy. Go to the York City store and you can make your virtual turnstile donation. Thank you for support this afternoon. We hope you're enjoying the fair. It's sunny, warm April afternoon. 1-0 to the Reds. 1-0 to the Blues. One shot. The Reds have scored. And it's the Blues who lead 1-0. Chance. A bit of height in the box. A bit of noticeable height from some of the Blues players over the Reds. But the ball coming in from Keller. Lifts the ball in. Good ball in. Anybody there? There is a back stick. Oh, and it's gone all the way across. Oh, pass has come back to Keller. Really thrust out the danger. It's going to be a corner to the Blues. Great ball in there from Keller. And a Blues player. His hands on his head and realises that it was a great chance to test the keeper in there. He went sideways instead of going. Ball in. Oh, bad work. Keller has the ball. Can't get the Blues just coming through. Pratt has it now. Turning, finds a great ball. And now there's a chance for the block off the Reds. It's 3-on-2. Scargill. Going forward, takes the shot. Oh, what a great strike! That's Scargill. He's used to it. 1-1, a great goal there. Take a bow, Joe Scargill. Yeah. minutes on the clock, so the Blues lead didn't last that long. Bootham Crescent. Last catch at the Crescent. It's great entertainment. Now I'm pleased to say we've got 200 viewers. Fox, back to Edmonds. Cuts inside. Ball across. Opportunity for a shot if you can turn. Plays it across.
Out to him.
And the shot comes in. Sam Pamba. Ball away. And the Reds again on the charge. And the man hit the crack. Keeper's coming out. Going out to stop the ball. So it's with McGregor. Kicks the ball forward, finds Fox. Halfway. Fox to take it, well, leaves it to Edmonds. Edmonds throws it in. Brooks back to Keller. Keller, ball over the top. Johnson. The bringer, the keeper, going to have a long thing here. Oh, this rubbish of tappy-tappy, it's going to be there. So James Brown launches it. He goes on halfway, with a flick header. Cunningham loses the ball to Tune. Tune passes across back to the red one. The ball back. Brooks back has it. Plays it inside. Fox doesn't get the ball. Puts out the man. It's Rayleigh. Dummies his man. Plays it inside to Cook. Cook finds Scargill. Just can't keep it in George. It's an entertaining game so far. No substitution made either. Five players from either side. Eager to get up. So far, neither manager has listed his invitation to the referee changes. Throwing to the Reds. From Cunningham plays it down the line, finds it back to him. Making steady. Steady yardage, nothing spectacular. Throws it down. Allen spins his controls and goes out of play for a Blues throw on the far side there. Owen Willis, the seaside monster man, looks like he's going to take the throw in. Throws the ball in. Flip header from Chiu. Walling has the ball. And Rayleigh. Nowak. Dummies both a man and also himself. Allowed. Ooh, trying to challenge for the second grade. Doesn't get it. Fox wins it. Lifts the ball over. Great interception. The Reds defender gives a little spin. To Scargill. He's all over the pitch. Second is Joe Scargill. Ball's played forward, but Keller. Brooks back to the game. Scrap it for James Allen. Walling. Back to George. James Allen. Intercepted by Edmonds. Fox. There's a little flick. Goes by Cook. Nice Brooks back, who puts a little ball through. And keeping gets it in the offside. The Blues bench, who are in front of the linesman at the moment. I think it was well done, the set to him. A little banter being exchanged. James Brown clears. And finds Brooks back. Blues are on the attack again. He's getting through. Through to Keller. Keller finds Tune on the left wing. He's going to put a ball in, puts inside, gets onto his right foot. Brooks Bank has it. It's James Allen for the Reds. Plays the ball forward on halfway. Pitts has it, a nice little reverse turn. It's now George Allen. Strong challenge, referee. Atkins says no. Fair challenge, play on. Looked okay from here. Ball now. Fox would have been through. The referee is. Oh, we're going to have a VAR. We have got a VAR. So, it's an artist with an easel. We'll have an answer in about 6 hours' time. Oh, we're having a drinks break. So, 1-1 after 26 minutes of this last game at the Crescent charity match. The Blues and the Reds, all proceeds spent for today's game, the youth team, the charity. Players and managers from both sides are paid to be involved today by this live stream broadcast from virtual Tuesday City, just like yourself, all donations, big or small. Please go to the auction store.
Extension cable in the room.
Looks like we've made some changes as well. Later now, the Reds on the break, Joe Scargill. Great finish. Right, we're back underway. Fox has the ball. Oh! There's another one there. Shot in and headed off Joe Scardia, but went over the keeper. Four shot just went on. Right then, it's going to be a Blues corner. Cross, well played by the Reds. It's going to be a corner over at this near side. And Keller to take it. There's the next one. Ball in. Headed away by Wally. Wally. He told me from the game. Wally has the ball. And Fox gets it back. Roberts lifts the ball through. There's been no one there. It's a keeper. Brian. There's a bit of time. Getting the ball to the edge of the pen, so nobody from the Blues can be fit for. And it's a throw. To Scargo. Now the captain's on the line. Ball through by Cunningham. Intercepted. Handball. Handball. And a chance for the Blues on halfway.
Go on, Rob.
He's giving me some advice. My advice is more is less. Spear has the ball, plays the ball forward. Place the ball forward, 27 for the Blues. Quick one. much in the in swinger. Not as much height now in the Blues. Well, not the best of all. And the Blues player gone down. And the chance for a goal. Oh, it is a goal. The ball was loose and it was mopped up by somebody I can recognise. He'll be happy with that. 2-1 to the Blues. Goal scorer in 12, Curtis Roberts. 35 minutes on the clock. It's the Reds 1, the Blues 2.
To keep hearing the I thought it was a wasp, and it's Tom's drawing. That's my fucking he's there. He isn't going.
The Blues are on the attack again. Number 7, Toby Johnson, goes past a few. Great save from James Brown. Looked like it was going into the corner, but great save. Keeps the book down 2-1. The Reds to break. Oh, yeah. Blues get the ball back. Keller just does a spin, beats his man, and then he lost his footing, is the best way to describe that. Reds have the ball back. Now a chance if we play the ball through. Del O'Brien, down this left hand side. Little ball with Ollie Cook, back to O'Brien, back to Cook. Very dry. Referee says no. The Reds bench. Not happy.
Definitely a penalty.
See them given. But the Blues now are breaking. With Roberts, scoring the second goal. Plays the ball through to Tune. But Scargill mops up the danger. Now the Reds have the ball with Walling. The Reds go straight to Keller. And now it's back to Tune. Tune lifts the ball in. Johnson didn't get to it. Beaten to it by Rayleigh. Now the Reds attacking through the middle. Ball through the middle, chance, but just a bit too much. Dominic McGregor comes out, clears any danger, finds Tune. Play the ball back to Rob Spirrell and finds the ball in turn to Keller. Keller, centre of the pitch. Rowley has it. Now the Reds, it's one to it's just one way and the other. Jack Moore has the ball. And it goes out and breaks the Blues. Gary Van der Veer. Bit of a clash of heads. Referee stops the game just to make sure that everyone's okay. Joe Rogers, Tom Hoare. But, better to be safe than sorry. Drop. 38 minutes, 2-1 to the Blues. Blues play the ball back. Wayne looking for some space, doesn't find the ball. Ball goes to eventually Curtis Roberts. Wayne manages to get the ball back. He'll be looking to play the ball forward, plays it inside. Well, Walling is beaten by Collar to the ball. Keller now coming forward. Is he going to be for Tune on that left wing? He does. Tune puts it aside. Oh, beats his man, beats Cameron. Ball over the top. Oh, and another corner. Doing well there, Tune. It's a corner now to the Blues again. Which I imagine Tune will take. Manager Simon Knight for the Blues on the at the moment. And of course, becomes so. Suit and booted for the occasion. So Tune puts the ball down in the corner. Flag by the pops down transfer hook. Ball lifted in. Goes to the penalty spot where he finds 27, the head of Joe Rodgers. Van der Veer is now hustling for the ball. It's a throw. I think to the Blues. Van der Veer to take it. Everyone's a sub after the drinks break. Haven't seen much of him. Let's see what he can do. Oh, is he going to take it? Yeah, he takes it now. Good ball in. Good high. Oh, and a free header. Fox parried by keeper Brown. Back to Fox. And the line of goal. Fox has put it over the top with the goalkeeper. Fox will be disappointed with that. A great chance, the ball was loose, he was free. There's no Reds players around him. He's finally looking for the top goal. He's fired it over, lost his balance. A great ball in there by Van der Veer. Fox had two good chances. So, Reds try. Clear. Good Whaley. Ball goes to Rodgers. Cook gets it back for the Reds. Plays it to Cunningham. Cunningham plays a ball down the line. But Tom Wrigglesworth has the ball. The ball is launched forward. But Rodgers now back to McGregor. The ball forward by Spiro. Rob Lee has the ball. If you saw the Sun newspaper this morning, there's a great article featuring Steve Watson. Last time Newcastle won at Liverpool, 1-0, 77. Steve Watson is the goal scorer. Meet you, Steve Watson, today's son. Ball in from the Reds. It's miscontrolled, and a chance now for the Blues, although they don't have many. It's Bootham, determinedly scared. It's back in the hands of McGregor, goalkeeper for the Blues. Fox now, what a space for the both forward lines. Fox now, play a ball, he is, he's playing a ball across to Chu, but great interception there by Andy Cunningham. Heads the ball back into the safe hands of James Brown. 2-1 to the Blues. 42 minutes on the clock. We did have a drinks break, so there's probably a little bit more time left before we get to half time. This last game at the Crescent. Johnson has got the ball for the Blues. Finds Chu and puts a great ball across to Fox in space. He's going to cut inside again. He is. Lost the ball. Warren has it now for the Reds. Chance to come forward. Van der Veer doesn't know where to call go. Plays the ball. Gets out of space. It's Rodgers to Fox. Fox plays the ball inside to Keller. Keller plays the ball forward and in space. Johnson, who finds Tune. Tune plays the ball in. Where Brown gets it, but he can only play the ball. Fox, bit of pressure now. The keeper got it, but bubbled it. The Blues has now all over this Keller. Chance for number 12. Takes a shot, blocked. Another chance. Great goal. Looks like Chief from here has made it 3-1 to the Blues. Here's Chris June, he's scored at the Sheepo end. I don't know if you're going to hear about that today. 44 minutes on the clock, Reds 1, Blues 3. So Reds to kick off, 3-1 down.
I'm
just stepping up against the red-shirted up. Tom Brown has the ball. Cuts inside. Plays across the line to Scargill. Walling has it. Ball in. Rodgers perhaps sitting back a little bit. Ball finds its way forward. Joinson. Intercepted by Scargill. Gets the ball forward to Cook. The Reds will be looking for a goal before half time. Give them something for the second half. Good ball through. But Rob Lee can't get there from McGregor, who clears over the halfway line. Finds the red shirt to Wallace. Cunningham. Cunningham plays it to Tom Moore. Plays it back to Tom Brown. The attention of Toby Joyson, smacking his ankles. But he's managed to find the ball through to Paul O'Brien. He plays the ball forward to Tom Hay. Gregor plays the ball forward. Foxing. William in the room. Gets past Tom Brown. He's going to play a ball across the tune. He is. Tuna now coming forward. Lays the ball forward to Curtis Roberts. But Scarborough gets the ball and clears to midfield. There's a run from Tom Hay down the middle, but that's not been spotted. Instead, the win. Tom Riddles is thwarted by the Lions' flag. And we've reached half time in the last ever game at the present. In aid of charity. Of the York Teaching Hospital Charity and the York City Football Academy. At the time, it's the Reds 1, the Blues 3. So welcome back to the second half. The Reds versus the Blues. There will be a delay. We're waiting for the cameraman.
Tom, where's Danny?
So like in the Premier League, the floor manager will give the man ready to start. Changes at half time. Goalkeeper wise for the Reds, the Brown brothers have changed. So in goal for the second half will be Thomas Brown. Tom Brown. For the Blues, in goal for the second half will be Richard Loft, who's replaced Dominic McGregor. So we have a few minutes just to remind you again that today's game is a charity match in aid of the York Teaching Hospital Charity in York City Football Club Academy. All the players from outside are paid to be involved today via the live stream broadcast. The virtual turnstile facility is open for donations this afternoon.
There he is.
Everybody who has contributed and everybody who's watching had a maximum peak viewing audience this afternoon. 230. I'm delighted to say the cameraman has returned. Getting underway.
15 minutes after that.
Very sure. It's caught out by the short half time. Back to your match referee, Craig Atkin. So Reds all to play for in the second half. 3-1 down. They get underway. James Brown. James, who played the first half in goal. Has the ball, plays the ball inside to James Allen, finds Newark. He's had the ball intercepted by Sam Bamber, and the ball is shielded by throwing to the Reds. And Tom Brown. Brown throws the ball down the line, doesn't get much purchase on it, but Phil finds a Blues head. Brooks back plays the ball forward. Ball is played in. Good interception by Cronin. Tom Moran plays. The referee has given a goal kick. Officials, I thought we were allowed to get helicopter, then we were saying the answer. Right then, ball is going to be played forward. By Brown. It's played back. Toby Johnson with a chance, keeper's come long way off his line, puts the ball off, he's able to play. Quick release. Gets some distance on it, probably controls the ball. Still has it. Looking to play the ball down the line, he finds Lee. Flip there from Allen, and now Lee has the ball. Sturdy challenge from Allen. Rodgers with the throw, the Blues. Lewis plays the ball back to Rodgers. Returns the ball, but throws with a loose pass, gives the advantage back to the Reds. A real chance now. 2-1 down, looking to get an early goal in the second half. Tom Hall. Good ball in, but it's gone over everyone's heads. It must be. Woff has saved it. If the referee has been a foul. Still 3-1 to the Blues. Oh, is on this right hand side. Rob Lee plays the ball inside. Didn't find his hand though. It's cleared by Rodgers. Rodgers plays the ball forward. Great chance for Toby Johnson here. Johnson goes past the ball. Good save by the keeper. The play back to him. Cleared off the line by him. No work. Great dash. Forward. Cunningham, down to Lee, Lee turns, looking to play inside. Ian Willis, the ball finds its way back to Rob Lee. Rob Lee now, going down the wing, plays the ball inside. The blues clear. Chance now, is he going to play it across? He is. Philip does well. Yeah. That's the fourth goal of the afternoon. Converted by number 10, Chris Brooksbank. The Reds 1, the Blues 4. That goal coming in the 50th minute. A mountain to climb now for the Reds. I'm sure they're not going to get James Brown plays the ball back. Walling delivers his man. McGregor over the ball. Played in goal first half. I think this is going to be a shot. It is. Yeah, collected. In the base goal last half. Cunningham has the ball. Cuts it short. Switch ball from Allen. Back to Hay. And now we've got two on line. Wigglesworth, a bit of room for Moran, puts it aside to his second line. Second line, but the ball is intercepted. Halfway, and safety first from Cunningham, plays it all the way back to his keeper. Watches it big, finds halfway. Brooks Bank has it. Tom Hay now intercepts for the Reds. In room, beats his man. Great chance. Oh! Well, they'll be disappointed. He hasn't worked the keeper there. Raised it over the bar. Neat bit of skill. Beats his man. Goes on for power. So 4-1 to the Blues.
Come on, lads, look up.
At the end of the game, we're going to have a penalty shootout to finish the afternoon. Somebody's going to be the Keith Houchin and somebody's going to be the Jimmy Quinn. City fan at a certain age, remember James Quinn skying the ball on Tuesday night. 1-0. Ball forward by the Blues.
Oh! What a goal!
Chris Prosper. Ball through on the volley. 5-1. Great goal for Chris Brooks Bank. Second of the afternoon for Brooks Bank. Five goals in the second half. That mountain is getting even steeper for the Reds now. 5-1 again. Long shot though. Lifting the ball forward. Waft has done well. George Allen is terrier-like to get the ball. But Owen Willis keeps straight and gets the ball clear. Hobbling. And a ball's forward, James Brown. And a goal. Tom Brown. Cutting him down and the player cuts inside. Brooks plays the ball across to Moran. Moran coming forward, captain of course for Brooks. Plays the ball forward, but intercepted by Edmonds. Now the ball is played forward, Brooks Bank on a hat trick. Plays the ball inside to Bamba. Bamba can't find his man, intercepted by Moran. The ball is now played forward to George Allen. Allen finds Lee. Lee plays a nice ball back to Allen. Turns. Takes the shot. James Brown. He's looking to clear. Gives it the big one. There's Tom Wigglesworth. Wigglesworth now going forward. The Reds hit back into him. Pressure. There's the danger. The ball forward. You always feel that when the ball's forward, pace. The Blues attack. He's got something on the legs. Simon Hyde, the manager of the Blues, looking to make a couple of changes. 5-1 up. Offside with a sweep play from the Blues.
Owen, you okay?
So Reds to clear from goalkeeper Tom Brown. Halfway. James Brown. Chance for Rob Lee now to run. Now Owen Willis, defender, plays the ball in. And doesn't get a flick. There's a flick and a chance for him. There's a goal. Good play, pressure on Rob Lee. And number 17, James Brown. He feels good. Some hope now for the Reds. 12 minutes into the set now. Blues making a change. Rob Spirit has come back on. Taking the place of Joe Rodgers. Does down to Rob Lee. Keeps the ball in. It's the linesman's flag up just going through the ball. George Allen sets the header. Rob Lee has the ball. machine again. Oh, it throws it. Roberts has it. Looks at the danger. The ball is cleared. James Allen looking to launch the ball into the Blues box. Tune gets his tweet, plays it the wrong way, and then a head over and another goal. By Edmonds, and suddenly we've got a game on. Reds 3, Blues 5. Looking like the first goal of the afternoon, a headed back pass. Turns up the Reds, and I wish to have the
edge
now. Certainly the
inside
to make some changes. Roth clears the ball. Challenge. And Tom Moran. Fair one. Ball played in. Woff gets it. Woff gets it. He clears it to Cullion. Splits the ball through. So he has it, but the Blues now have a chance to break. With 25, Rob Spira. Chance to shoot, does. Takes a deflection. Peter Young. So, corner to the Blues, in swinger. Far side. Plenty of men in the box. Cleared by Tom Moran. Going to be another corner. The Blues leading 5-3 at half time, so even Stevens ball in, keeper takes, fumbles it, but just take it, looking to release and looking to take it quick. There's a chance, the Reds are on a break here, the ball's through to Lee, he's got acres of space to run into. Takes the shot. Keeper. Tom Hague was pushing for it. The ball's found its way back to Lee. Another chance. Plays the ball in. Aaron Willis clears. Cunningham though gets the ball. Plays it in. A bit of pressure off from the Reds, but just scores. Take advantage. But Simon Hyde, the Blues manager, making changes. It looks like up to four changes could be made here. With Danger and Fox returning. Keller. So will be also coming out. Four changes to the Blues. Coming off Tune Roberts. So 5-3 to the Blues. Get back underway. Jim! Reds have it though. Brown finds Cunningham inside, going backwards though. Not going the right way. And a chance now for the Blues. 2-3, and this contract from the Brigger. Puts his hand up to apologise. Great chance there. And Brent Sobey comes Brooks back. Ball played long. Bamba clears for the Blues. Foley finds his counterpart number 11 for the Reds, who plays the ball down to Nick Pratt. Pratt with a ball across. Oh, a bit of indecision there between goalkeeper and defender, but defender clears. And again at the other end, some indecision, the defender and the goalie. Tom Brown having to come charging in with two Blues players charging on the ball. Player goes into the seat. Division stand where all the seats have disappeared now. Comes through the gate, but it's now also in effect sitting there. People's guard. The ball across from the Blues. Intercepted by Cunningham. John Hague has it, clears it forward. Oh, great spin and turn. From James Brown. Rob Lee. Lewis. Battle for the ball. Lewis. Keller. Just come on. Fresh legs back. Plays the ball forward. Finds Brooks back to Keller with a pinpoint, sir. It's a goal. Not too sure if it hit the back stanchion and came straight out, but from here, certainly the ball didn't nestle. It came straight out with a well worked goal and a great strike there. Well placed in the corner from number two, James Keller. Makes it the Reds 3, Blues 6. Simon Hyde, Blues manager, really a little bit easier. I'm sure Richard Dobbinham, the Reds manager, knows this game is still not. So the ball is down to James Brown. Loses the ball, Keller comes forward for the Blues, plays it forward into a bit of space for Brooks back. He's going to win the battle against Moran, but Moran just slides in. The ball goes out for clear, far side. Remember the virtual turnstile facility still open this afternoon for the donation. Let's go to the Rooks in the store. The ball is played across. The Fox has it. A shot deflected into the hands of the keeper. Today's game, charity match. The York teacher, hospital charity. Played forward to James Brown. It's a loss for the ball, dispossessed. Launched forward there. It's coming in. It's a nice bit of skill, bit of keeping up it to beat Spiral. Plays player back. Goes all the way back to the goalkeeper. Can't pick it up. He's going to clear with his feet. Does that. Fox gets the ball forward to Keller. Keller gets the ball back. Keller's through on goal. And I'm not too sure if there's going to be a goal given here, but there's certainly a collision between Keller and the goalkeeper. Cope. People look to receive the don't really think he's been the goal. Give attention to both players. I think it stays at 3-6.
Get an injury on the yard guys.
Just getting himself up. Pleasingly not injured. I'm going to go to another drinks break. So, 23 minutes of the second half. Reds, supported by the St. Leonard's Hospice 3. The Blues, supported by the Waitrose and Colfax 6. This last game at the Crescent charity match, all proceeds will be split between the York Hospital and the charity and the Yorkshire Football Club Academy. Donations are still being received this afternoon on the virtual text and message. Those donations are in the Well, the ball is on the spot, so I don't know. I think the Blues might have done that. Just, did the referee put it? I think they'd give a goal, aren't they?
Did he touch it though? How did he touch it? No, Keller's running through to it, didn't get hold of it. Quite a good keeper, whoever played the ball through. Did you give it out?
Oh, the Brooks bank's got two, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have got 6 goals, but Brooks bank's got 2. Roberts has got 2.
You're going to have to take your socks off in a bit.
It is, yeah, it's 7, yeah. So the drinks break is over, and it would appear the Blues has lost attack. The ball ended in the net. Coming together between the Blues and the goalkeeper. The referee has given the goal, so it is the Reds 3, Blues 7.
I don't know, Jeff, did it?
We believe. Otherwise, they would have kicked off. So, 7-3 now to the Blues, who are coming forward again. 6 minutes straight through to the goalie. Tom Brown showed no effects from the collision he sustained. And he kicks it wide. He finds Rob Spoon. Reds and halfway. Fox has the ball, plays it to Keller, can't keep it in. Dan O'Brien now. James Allen, back to O'Brien. Uses the ball, Van der Veer now has it. Forward. Play. Yes, Van der Veer. James Allen.
yours this afternoon, celebrating 80th birthday. So if you're still watching, Brian Cunningham, your grandson has been playing this afternoon for the Reds. Happy birthday, Brian. That comes from everyone in New York City. Oh! What a goal! That's made you happy, Brian, because the Reds have scored again. Great cross from the corner and a bullet header. And he's happy with that. Number 10, George Allen, has made it the Reds 4, the Blues 7. Game on again. Edmonds clears for the Blues, finds Fox. Ball played inside. Van der Veer lifts the ball over. Spiral now has the ball. That's clear. Lewis has the ball. Van der Veer plays the ball in. Toby Joyson gets the ball. Sam Fox does a spin, finds a bit of room, finds Keller, back to Willis, he loses the ball, forward, George Allen with room, looking up, puts the ball in, just a little bit forward in front of Tom Keller. Certainly not giving up the game, the Reds. They've got a chance. Long ball forward. Johnson can't get there. And it's the Reds. Scarborough, who finds Allen. Back to Scarborough. Looking ground coming forward. Lifted the ball through. Off track. Offside trap is beaten. And a great chance. Lifts the ball over. That's a goal. What a move. Number 8, Tom Hague makes it Reds 5, Blues 7. We do have a match on. Simon Hague, the manager of the Blues, makes a change immediately. For sure at the back, they're perhaps the legs, a bit leggy of the Blues now, so youngsters in the red side. The older members of the Blues defence. Richard Debenham, the Reds manager, delighted with his second half performance and come back. Got to keep it going now. Wally gets the ball. And Cook gets in front of Keller. Loses the ball, the Blues are attacking. We've got a man down for the Reds. Blues, Reds now charging forward. Didn't get the ball through. Now to come end to end, Spiro. Blues players has just said he's very tired. Fox charging forward with fresh legs, hits one from distance, but not trouble the goalkeeper that. And a change. McGregor coming on. Wearing the 58 shirt. He's replacing. Sam Bankman. So it's Reds goalkeeper, Tom Brown, to clear. Finds Cook. Now it's Moran. Launches the ball forward for excuse it. Disappointed with that one. Reds come back into this game. Push
Bartok, McGregor, first half goalkeeper for the Blues. Lost his marker, but the ball's got through to the keeper, Brown. Brown clears. Nice little move from the Reds, and the ball through. That's the chance for O'Brien. Plays the ball inside, where he finds Allen. Allen shows the ball. Plays it back to Pratt, but loses the ball to Keller. Keller now has a bit of time. Fox in midfield. Looking for support, but Fox is going to have to do it all himself because there's no. And he's stopped on his run by the Reds player. Buys a bit of time. Keller to take it. He's going to launch one. So before that can happen, the Blues are making the changes. The hard pitch and the heat. Some wholesale changes from the Blues side. Sees the departures of Willis, Rodgers, Sullivan. They're replaced by Tune has come on. Brooks back. So the ball going to be played in by Keller, plays it short to McGregor. Is McGregor going to hit one? Definite chip in, finds his man, but Blues player come on to it. O'Brien now breaking. Keller gets the ball back, finds Fox. Plays it onto the wing. Roberts. Roberts plays across. Oh! Tune gets his head to it. Hits the crossbar. Great chance there. Just Tune to extend the movement. Well, it's 7-5. And we've had 35 minutes. Just a reminder again, there will be a penalty shootout to final. We will be having a penalty shootout to the same. Enjoy that. Who's the Hao Chin? Who's the Jin? You can smash one against the crossbar. I think Parky did that against Sophie. So here we go, back on the pitch, where the Blues just thwarted a Reds attack. Keller, a little push. It's going to be launched long by Joe Scargo. Plenty of red shirts going forward. In search of a sixth goal. Flicked on, can't get much distance. It's cleared by Brooks Bank. For a throw. Looking to launch it long, the Reds. Brooks Bank gets the header again. Bit of a push there, look like a push. Just to mention again to our two linesmen, father and son, we were paid to run the line this afternoon, Martin and Matt Crosby. Had some action, some shouts from the ball played forward, Reds on the attack again, long shot there from Pratt. Took it a bit too much, finds waft in the Blues goal, he looks to clear. Fox does a spin, gets the ball back eventually, looking to go forward again, gets the ball forward, cuts inside. Tom Long picks the ball up and safe, clears it to quarterback. Thank you. So the Reds have it. Clear. Long ball forward. Brooks back gets the head on it, but doesn't do anything with it. And there's a 3-on-2 here. Ball across, lofted over the goal. And the Reds have scored again. It's now 7-6. And is the comeback going to be achieved? The same goal in the afternoon for Tom Haig. Like 7-6. And that seventh goal for the Blues now. Slightly controversial, but at the moment, the only difference between the two sides. And I reckon we've got about 6 minutes left, perhaps. Ball across. Reds definitely with their tails up now. Back to Scargill. Very poorly back to the keeper. Launched it big. But swept up by Keller. 14 shots from Joris van der Veer. But well wide. But not worth it. Keeper plays it short to Scargill. Puts inside to Cook, but does a spin.
One down.
Finds Allen.
Oh, 5 minutes, come on.
Sorry, Dan. Come on. Roberts for the Blues, throws it in. Where Van der Veer throws the ball to Curtis. This is shot, keeper saves it. Curtis Roberts cuts inside. That's a goal kick. Let's make an assistant speedy winger, Rob Lee, coming on. He's replaced Nick. So manager Richard Dale thinking a bit of pace up front now. Chance to get that seventh goal. But it's Fox for the Blues, cuts inside, gets a good bobble, plays the ball across. Fox with the shot, takes the deflection, takes away. Tune has it, leaves it for the corner flag. It's going to be a corner to the Blues. 7-6, around about 5 minutes to go. Tune's take the corner, and Slayer. Got the height on it. Has lost it, and the Reds are now on her. From Keller. If he didn't get that, the Reds would have gone through. McGregor gets his head to it. Fox. Moran forward.
Get out!
Rob Lee. Got it, but then lost it. Brooksbank going forward. It's McGregor. At the moment, the Blues sort of hanging on in belief that they can win. The Reds determined and scrapping to go forward. Throwing everything at it. I said at the start it could be an epic. They haven't let us down yet. Tom Haig to take the throw in. George Allen waiting in the middle. A lot of blue players back now. Reds, a late charge, number two, Joe Scargill charging into the box. This little delaying tactics there by Simon Knight, the Blues manager. Not making a change, making a change. Chance for a shot for a doesn't go. Now the Blues are on the chance. It's a 2-on-2. Fox has got the ball. Reds have come back, though. There's not many Blues coming forward. Now you can tell that it's more of a defensive. Oh, it's a foul! And I think that could be that. What a cross by Fox. And what a goal for number 7, Toby Joynson. On the volley, keeper, no chance. It's Red 6, Blues 8. Blues players. There's some substitutions. I think we've got less than a minute left, and I think everyone's coming on for the last minute.
Let's go. Come on.
Everyone on. We're all going to go on. So, yeah, it's a bit of a free for all. It's more of rugby numbers, not football numbers. I think we're into the last minute. And that's it. Full time whistle. Blues 6, the Blues 8. Congratulations to both teams on a great game of football. What a fitting way to say farewell to the present. We're going to now have a penalty shootout to end. To readdress the balance, Dominic is now facing Reds number 11, captain Tom Lowe. Mm-hmm. and steps up. And scores. So for the Blues now, Samuel Fox. Long run up. Straight down the middle. With the keeper of the eye, straight down the middle. James Brown. Good goal. For the Blues is Christian. Scores it again down the middle. He's happy with that one. Next up for the Reds, George Allen. Next for the Blues, Toby Joynson. Scored the goal at the end of the game. Oh, he's hit the woodwork! And this. Take advantage of the Reds.
Said it'd be on YouTube forever. Just walk up and put it in a corner. Just
so a miss there from Tom Haig, and next up for the Blues, Owen Willis. Oh, he looks straight at the keeper. Literally. James Allen stepping up for the Reds. And another save. Just what we like to see, lots of saves and misses. So, after five penalties each, it's 2-2. Rob Spearell to step up next, as I said, we have mentioned earlier, the York City match day commentator.
Long earthbound, this.
There's a goal. Very happy with that. Steps up for the Reds. Needs to convert to keep them level. Oh, a nicely taken penalty there from Crouch. 3-3 after six. Sam Bamba next for the Blues. Oh, the stutter. Loading the pitch, he says. To Newark. Scoring the first goal of the afternoon. Unfortunately, a deflection into his net. Can make amends now. Oh, an interesting penalty to take, but the keeper saved it. So it's 3-3 after seven. Seth Sowerby for the Blues. To Whaley. So the advantage now to the Blues, 4-3 after 8 each. Saves from Brooks Bank. Certainly been a keeper's penalty shootout so far. Throws it down the middle. To make it 4-4 after 9. Zav Edmonds next for the Blues. Woodwork is taking a battery. So, Rob Lee to give the Reds the advantage. Okay. 4 to the Reds. After 10 penalties each. Stepping up for the Blues next, Curtis Roberts, scorer of 2 goals during the winter time. Junior Quinlan. James Scargill. For the Reds to press out the advantage. Great strike from Scargill. Rodgers. Finds the corner. James Walling. Sends the keeper the wrong way to make it 7-5. James Keller has an impressive game for the Blues this afternoon. Next up for the Reds, Tom Wrigglesworth. Ooh, sends it over. Makes it 7-6 to the Reds. Two, three penalties each. Joris van der Veer. He sends it into the top corner. Not to be. Richard Waft for the Blues. Saved by the keeper. Peter Nowak. Oh, top corner. Goalkeeper, I don't think is either A, ready or B. Couldn't believe it. Final one, I believe, for the Blues, Peter Marshall. Scores. The manager is now coming up to take one. Suited and booted. So, Simon Hyde, manager of the Blues. Will he be singing the Blues? Of the Reds, Richard Debenham. Match officials are going to take one, starting with Martin Crosby. I think he had a better flat afternoon with the flat. Now his son, Matt. And now the referee is going to take one. And scores. To go down in history, Craig Atkin, the scorer of the last ever goal at Bootham Crescent. I hope you've enjoyed your afternoon on the live stream. It's been an honour and a privilege to call Bootham Crescent our home.